Hey guys, it's Matty17 back again. So today for you, I've got a pretty interesting machine. It is a Taco brand, but anybody who sort of knows a little bit about different types of washing machine might be able to pick up on who actually made this and what machine it actually is underneath the costume. There's the details. I think the drawer is a big giveaway. So it's actually a Hoover. It's a Hoover in Teco clothing, shall we say. It's 9 kilo, 1400 RPM spin. It's got pretty standard Hoover programming. You can only have 90 degrees if you do the cotton with a pre-wash. The normal cotton cycle just goes up to 60 on Hoover machines. The cotton cycle was called colored. So just the normal cotton cycle that goes to 60 was called colored. Your options are strong wash, which is it maintains the heat in the cycle all the way throughout. Extra rinse, which is the same as the extra rinse on most machines. It just adds more water and adds another rinse. Delay start, your temperature selection, your easy iron selection, start stop button. You can select your spin speed, and you can also select the wash time in three different stages. So that just informs the kilogram mode on what it selects as terms of a wash time based on the load. So it's got the kilogram mode here, which flashes when it's sensing the load and figuring out how much washing is in there, so that it can wash for the appropriate amount of time and with the appropriate amount of water. And then yeah, you select the wash time and it will do it. It all works together. It's all very clever. I do love the door on it. The door is actually quite unique. Big 9 kilo capacity. It's a brushed motor. Today we're going to do a load of just cleaning cloths, cleaning towels, bath mats, mop heads, just to give it a good old cotton 60 wash. So I'll be back when I've loaded it up. Alright, so we're all loaded up. Shut the door. So for this wash, I'm just using some Savex washing powder. And I'm going to use a touch of washing soda as well, just to boost it. Have to turn my kitchen tap on. I've got this very much set up as a portable at the minute in my kitchen, so I don't have to move machines around in the laundry room. So I can still do some filming. We're going to use the cotton cycle, 1400 RPM spin. I'm going to leave it at 60. I'm going to put the wash, I'm going to leave the, I'm going to knock the wash time down one, I think, and have it in the middle. We are going to have strong wash and we are going to have extra rinse. It's 307 all up, not too bad. Yeah. All right, and away we go. Machine's not in the greatest of conditions internally. I think they would have been
When I picked it up, it was set on quick 30, so I'm sure that might have been the go-to cycle for the people that were using it, which is a shame, but yeah. Apologies for the water you can hear in the background, that's just my tap dribbling. We've jumped down to 241 just now. I'm doing the final top off of the wash. main wash now. Heated up to 60. Don't think I'll ever get through a video without the dogs barking. Don't think it's possible. Charlie, Dexter, come here. No. There must have been a leaf blow past the house or something. I didn't realise this machine went into rinse at 146 left to go, but there you go. Machine doesn't like the kitchen floor. Unlevel. There you go, it's some up close sunblock action. Now the dogs come to see what's happening. Hey Dex, it's okay baby. I can see there's still a bit of still a fair bit of grime in this machine really, but I wasn't intending on using it as a daily driver, but we shall see. then. That's well. Turn the tap back. There you go. Whether that's some sort of sunspot recovery, I don't know, but that was the first rounds. Bizarre. I think this wash has dislodged a lot of crap that's probably stuck in the filter, which means it's draining a little slower than normal, but it'll get there. Once it's finished this drain, I'll rip the bottom off it and try and get it back to draining normally. Thank you. next level. Final rinse.